Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you would like to see how I accomplished this teal cut crease, then just keep on watching. So starting out, I am getting concealing her eyes using the Proconceal in the shade Toffee. And I am using this palette right here. This is the Perfect 40 palette by Nickak. And I only use one color out of that palette. Oh no, actually I used two. That blue shade. And then this is the Crown palette. This is the Smoke Me Out 2 palette. And then I only used two colors, like I said, which was that blue and the silver shade out of that palette. So now that I applied that first shade out of that Perfect 40 palette, this was the blue out of the Crown palette. I'm using the BH Cosmetics brush. This was at the Smoky Eye Collection brush, just to basically give her eyes depth so that way I can start forming her cut crease. Now, this brush I already used in the beginning. I only used one shade for it. I didn't put no extra product on it. I'm just basically blending out that blue shade that I just put on there. And that blue was like a royal blue almost. So I ain't really, you know, put too much on there. But yeah, so I'm basically switching back and forth from those two brushes, that Wet n Wild brush, that white one, and that precision brush, just basically giving more depth to her eyes. So of course I did a lot of blending on this look, but honestly I only used two shades for that cut crease: the lighter blue, the teal blue, and the royal blue, which is on that precision brush right there. So okay, so now that I'm cutting the crease, she doesn't necessarily have hooded eyes, so I was kind of happy about that. Like, she has hooded eyes, but not as bad as mine. So what you want to do is make sure that your client eyes closed. Like, she had them open and I told her to close them right now. And you basically want to cut above, like I said, where the hood is, not necessarily where the hood is, but like where the eye socket stops. So like where you see like where the eye socket dips at. So that's exactly where I cut it at, just so it can literally form so her eye doesn't look like weird and nothing like that. But right here you see me patting. I'm basically like blending out the edges of the cut crease just so it can look smooth. I mentioned this on my last cut crease video, so if you haven't seen that video, the link will be above. But yes, I'm basically blending out the edges. I use whatever was left on that brush, that Wet n Wild brush, and then like right now, and then I use the precision brush with the royal blue color on there right now to just basically give depth to the edges of the cut crease. So the color that I'm using to pack on her cut crease was the first color that we used out of that Perfect 40 palette by Nickak, which was like a teal, kind of like periwinkle blue. And then I used a silver out of that same exact palette. I didn't put it in here. I don't know why. I just didn't record it. I don't know. But I just used the silver, the lightest silver that I could find out of that palette, the same exact palette I'm holding now. Just to pack it on right on the side of it, which is I'm doing right now. So the liner that I'm using is my favorite by Black Radiance. This is the Bold and Sexy liner. It's a two-sided liner. I always use this on my videos. I'm just giving her a nice little deep cat eye to go with her cat eye lashes. Thank you. right now I am priming her face using the Too Faced peach primer, and then the foundation that I use is Milani in the shade Chesnut. It's the same exact one I use. It's a 2-in-1 concealer and foundation. So the concealer that I used was by Proconceal in the shade Toffee. I didn't put too much on there because she didn't really want a lot of makeup on her face, which was fine. And then I'm using a beauty blender to blend it out. Now on to setting her face. I am using Jcat Pro Luxe Powder in the shade Porcelain. Y'all know this is my favorite setting powder. I don't know like why I love it so much. It just melts into your skin and it literally gives you this airbrush finish that is like, I don't know, unbeatable. But right now I am basically contouring her face using the this is the Wet n Wild bronzer in the shade Queensland, and then I'm on to my little cracked up black radiance pressed powder in the shade Black Coffee. So right now I am basically dusting away that Jcat powder using my LA Color contour palette, and I am just using like the medium brown shade in there to basically dust away all that powder and setting her entire face. Moving on to setting her face, I am using the NYX Finny Matte Setting Spray. And my favorite technique, y'all know, is to set in and press in that spray, locking in all that powder, giving her a natural face-like finish. And I use two different blushes. I use the Juvias Place blush. I don't remember the name of it, but I'll sure put it in the description box. And I also use Milani in the shade Berry Amore. And you know, I'm using my favorite palette by Academy of Colors. This is the highlighter palette, and I use those two golden shades. Last but not least are the lips, and I only use the brown liner and clear lip gloss that she had herself from MAC. And put that on there, and she looks absolutely gorgeous. The hair details will be in the description box below, and I love everything about this look all the way down to the dress, honey. Please feel free to subscribe before you guys leave. Don't forget to like and comment on this video, and thanks again for watching. Bye.